No, stop the intro. Stop that. Right, I can't even be asked to give this guy an intro. Put his picture up. Put the picture up. Oh. Wow, yeah. So I could end this right now and you'd probably know what I was talking about. Now, if there was anybody you could put in front of a fireplace to stop children burning themselves, it would be this guy. In fact, I'm sure I've seen this guy somewhere before.
Here we are, children. Come and get your lollipops.
The similarity to the child catcher doesn't end lollipops. There either. By all accounts, he's just as unpleasant to them in person.
Your daddy's a totally horrible person.
Go in, don't talk to us.
Go. Lots of people don't like your daddy, you know that. He's probably not told you about that. Anyway, lots of people hate him. Because he won't say how much he pays his... You know the nanny he looks after? Daddy doesn't pay her very much. Daddy says the minimum wage doesn't count for anything. Or the London living wage. Daddy doesn't pay the living wage. So poor Nanny Crook, who looks after you and wipes your bottom, she doesn't get enough money every week. But Daddy doesn't care, because he's too busy posing as a Latin-eating, orientated toff, which he does pretty well.
Ian Bone, described as a veteran anarchist by some and a lefty thug by others. And after seeing that footage, you can see why.
Simple question. You won't answer the question, will you?
For some reason, this guy thought it would be a great idea to not just attack Jacob Rees-Mogg, but his small young children as well. Jacob, as usual, handled the situation in his usual dignified and calm manner, and even after the event, has said that this was a very minor and short-lived incident. Now, I'm not a great lover of this current government, but does that really mean I can start harassing innocent children? His actions have been condemned by all sides of the political spectrum, but probably not by The Guardian. A while ago, Suzanne Moore wrote, "Bone Idol, the Shard Provocateur, is my kind of anarchist."
From Mr. Ian Bone.
So here's her kind of anarchist on Jonathan Ross back in 92.
The rich, the Tories, the Labour Party, they're all against us. We should get up off our knees and fight back against the bastards. I think, Jonathan, that you're basically a working class boy who's come from his working class roots, made good, got himself some nice clothes. There's nothing wrong with that. We want working class people to want the best. They shouldn't want to wallow in poverty like the left wants. Yeah. Wallow in poverty. We're so oppressed and so on. We're saying there is an alternative which says working class people can take control of their own lives, get rid of all these shithouses who dominate us, parasites on our backs. We can get rid of them. We are getting rid of them in our daily lives, and we will.
I don't want to be boring, but if we're going to Kenya, can you just moderate the language a tiny bit? Because it's kind of, just say down the chute, that would do, we get the message. Some of what you say, I think you make sense, but some of it I find, you know, quite offensive, frankly. It's like this thing, you brought out this calendar, which is hospitalised copper calendar. 1992.
Sells, I might say, 200,000 copies. So if everyone's so in favour of the cops, how are we selling 200,000?
Well, you see, you're saying in favour of working class people, and the majority of the police force are working class men and women. They're out there doing a job, and many of them, I'm sure, have entered the force because they think, I want to do something positive, I want to put something back into community.
We've just been talking in the last half hour about this events with Jacob Rees-Mogg and this class activist, class war activist. His name's Ian Bone, who was shouting at the children and saying, "Your daddy's a totally horrible person. A lot of people hate him."
It is on me. I mean, frankly, I think when you have these kinds of people, I just don't engage with them because that's what they thrive on. He's there to get some attention. He's not got a job. He doesn't do anything. He's got no purpose in life. And you know, I wouldn't have time to go round to an MP's house in the middle of the day because I've got job.
Yeah,
I've got
this is the whole point. He is an unemployed anarchist.
He's succeeded in getting the attention.
He certainly has. Although he doesn't like it when people were asking him about his own children and grandchildren. Apparently, he didn't want them involved in politics. Interesting choice. Well, look, let's talk about this with Talk Radio's political editor Ross Campbell, but also Neil Coyle, who's a Labour MP, not a fan of Jacob Rees-Mogg's politics, and both join us now. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
Ross Kemp, if we can start with you now. I mean, look, this video, it's on our website, it's on our Twitter feed at Talk Radio. It's gone completely viral. 1 million+ people have seen this video. I think people, to a man and a woman, have been horrified by it, whatever their politics. But I think there's also a lot of credit going out to Jacob Rees-Mogg for how he and his family stood there and refused to, they didn't lower themselves to the way that this other man, Ian Bone, was acting. But also that I was really impressed with the fact that my instinct would be get my kids away from this person, get them inside the house. And Jacob Rees-Mogg's reaction was, we are not going to be cowed. We're not going to run into our house. We're going to stand there united and stand firm. I would say, you know, A plus for parenting there. But in terms of the message going out about our politics, we're putting the question out today, you know, when did our politics get like this, that bringing in a politician's child would be acceptable? What do you think?
In terms of this individual and his aims, Class War is a non-aligned anarchist group. It doesn't support a particular political party. And to be honest, Julia, its main motivation seems to be to generate press and media coverage.
Yeah, although you say they're non-aligned, but Class War, I mean, the likes of John McDonnell, the Shadow Chancellor, has stood on platforms, you know, gone on demonstrations with them. The same banners keep appearing again and again. They certainly seem to be pretty close with a lot of the Corbynistas.
Well, two things. Obviously, I mean, personally, I think Jacob Rees-Mogg's, you know, stuck in a time warp from a different dimension. I can't think of a single thing we agree on, but I did send a private message to him yesterday to say how horrified I was to see it. I thought it was a really, really scummy thing to do. And what surprised me most was Jacob Rees-Mogg stood right there. If you really disagree with him and are protesting about him, why not have a go at him? Why not discuss the ideas or argue with him? Instead, they chose to shout at the kids. And I think that says a lot about the nature of the people involved. What worries me is that the level of coverage of this will actually appeal to some of the weirder, the sort of cranks at the end, both ends of the political spectrum, who, you know, they just want to be noticed. They want, you know, they'll feel it almost endorses their protest by having this level of coverage. And that's why many people are more nervous about entering politics or being in public life.
Now, I don't agree with everything Jacob Rees-Mogg says. I detest this government, and I'm most certainly working class. In fact, I haven't got a pot to piss in. But out of these two guys, who do I relate to the most? It's got to be Jacob. What say you?